All right, got a chance to check up with Chuck Grindstaff, a few presentations this morning at the analyst event. And you talked about three different components of our growth strategy. You talked about industry strategy, our organizational alignment, and then our technology vision. I'd like to talk to you a little bit about each of those elements.
Sure.
In the industry strategy section, you talked a lot about this solution mapping process. Mm-hmm. Can you give a little bit more information about how that actually works? That was pretty interesting.
Sure. Yeah, what we're trying to do, Chris, as you said, is really make sure that our vision of how to use our products is really well understood by our sales force, but most importantly by our customers.
Uh-huh.
Simplest way to do that, to look at the key elements of a particular set of activities within a company, call it maybe a solution thread or a technical thread, try to understand what decisions are made within each of those elements, might be a planning decision, maybe a set of technical decisions, maybe some simulation results.
Okay.
And you look across the activity set, connect them together with information flow, with process steps, and really understand what we can do today,
mm-hmm.
how we might want to refine and improve that, remove redundancies or waste, come up with the next version of that solution.
Okay.
Third version of that solution, and really use that as a roadmap for how we'll solve a problem. Maybe it's warranty and repair. Maybe it's designed for sustainability in a particular industry setting.
Okay.
So we've done this across a variety of industries, a variety of disciplines. We're continuing to do that faster and better, and it's given us a line of sight to how to optimize our investment. So instead of just making a feature and a function that might look to some as being a stranded feature and function, it's part of a whole process thread that our sales force, our customers can immediately see and understand.
And it's great because it sounds like the approach is not specific to one industry. It works on everything we've tried it on so far.
Absolutely works everywhere. The question is, and the reason we put so much focus on it there in the meeting was that we're really up in the ante. We're going kind of from a doing this around our core industries, major functions, out through the rest of the value chain. So that just broadens the value to us, broadens the impact of the approach to all of our products.
Great. The second point you talked about was the organizational alignment. Mm-hmm. Obviously, some of the big news you announced, your first post on the blog today, congratulations, is really trying to solve kind of this simultaneous equation of what we put in the solution, what we need for a solution, how we the product addresses that, and then, of course, the competitive and market pressures that go on.
Right.
How's this new organizational alignment going to help us solve that more consistently?
Well, we just talked about the industry side of things.
Mm-hmm.
So pulling all of our industry experts together into a very focused activity around understanding the semantics and the value by industry, by solution.
Right.
Number two, the big focus on CTO. So yes, we are very good at leveraging our R&D, leveraging the things like our visualization strategy, JT, our common modeling kernel, our D-cube tools. These kinds of modules that we've shared across the product lines have been very useful for us. As we go forward, there's more and more projects like our Active Workspace that span the entire suite of products, and the CTO's office can help us accelerate getting those staffed, funded, and to market. I think the Active Workspace, from inception to delivery, maybe 14, 15 months really of work. I'd like to get that whole cycle time down even further. CTO's office is helpful in accomplishing that.
Okay.
So that underpinning. Then we have the business segment, so we're adding some P&L responsibility, putting together some additional functions together with R&D, like marketing, product management. So we really have business units. They're sizable business units in and of themselves.
Sure.
We're calling them segments because they're part of the overall suite, but then we have the key leaders that are driving those segments. They can look at the development and the market needs by product. We've got the industry guys looking at the cube from the industry side, and we have GSS. It's organized around geographies. So that three-dimensional cube, industry, geography, and product all come together.
That's great. Yeah, so really just a triangulation, all solving their piece of it and then bringing all the elements together. That's
good. Just kind of simplify the complexity with a little bit of organization.
Perfect. Okay. Just the last point you brought up was the technology vision, and obviously a lot of interesting parts to that. But one of the things I wanted to pick up on, last week I was at Dreamforce, Salesforce.com's user conference, and one of the big themes there was gamification. You know, they're really trying to look into how can we make these things fun to use, not only easy to use, but fun to use.
Yeah.
How do you think something like Active Workspace fits into with a trend like that?
Well, Active Workspace, we are trying very hard to make sure that it's a flattened user experience, right? Mm-hmm. So like a game where you go in and really the things that you want to interact with are always available. Mm-hmm. There's not a big training process associated with it, at least most good games.
That's right.
There's feedback immediately on success or lack of success, right? So a game makes you feel good if you're making progress. So Active Workspace has many of those core attributes. It also has the notion of context, your role within that mm-hmm. context. It has the very visual feedback. It has the ability for high performance with the search engines. Mm-hmm. So kind of all those things together, flattened user experience, direct feedback on the results, ability to reach out and collaborate and do that instantaneously with the explicit and direct group of people that are involved in your mm-hmm. little area of design or big area of design. All those things come together. Maybe they're along the same lines as what you heard.
Yeah, it sounds just like the way I play Modern Warfare. So cool. Last question.
Yeah,
so this whole strategy, your whole presentation was all about lining this up for growth.
Yeah.
You care to shed a little light on what we can expect to see over the next 12 to 24 months in terms of growth from Siemens PLM software? Safe harbor statements applying.
Oh, yeah. Well, look, we're growing very rapidly right now. We have been for quite a while. Company's now 8,000 colleagues strong. It's really great to be part of that growth engine.
Mm-hmm.
Now, the organizational structure we talked about, some of the ways in which we're decomposing the problem to analyze it and optimize, those all go together to make sure that we've got not only where we are today well under control and optimized, but that we can grow much further.
Cool.
And whether that's further organic growth or whether that's growth through finding business partnerships mm-hmm. and other more strategic alignments with other companies, we have now a structure where we can do that. We can add new business segments, we can add new functions and capabilities that are cross product line, and we have the ability to add on new industries. So depending on where you add a partner and
where the opportunity
what
is.
You do, we've got a place to do that very effectively.
And we can do it quick.
Yeah.
Okay. Well, I appreciate it. Thanks for taking the time. I know
pleasure.
You've got a lot of folks to meet with,
yeah.
and it's going to be a good conference.
My pleasure.
All right, thanks.